So by the way, that's actually very risky, as you've got your thermostat wire, you've got your suction line and your whatever the other one is, but the copper tubing coming out. So if something went wrong and that edger kicked forward, probably be on the hook for a $500-$600 repair. So that's a bit of a gamble, you know, using the edger that close. But Brad, you may be saying to yourself, where are the water boxes, the meter mains that I see you take care of all the time? Very good question. And I believe they're under here. Now the next question is, do they have one box or two? I think we're just gonna do the one and call it good enough. Okay, let's talk strategy for a minute. Normally, I like to string trim everything first. If you string trim and then mow, you mulch up all those string trimming clippings. But if you mow and then string trim, whatever you string trim is just gonna be laying on top of the grass, right? So ideally, you string trim first. That being said, this yard is so tall and there's gonna be so much clipping and debris, it's not really gonna matter. This isn't gonna be in the background of the 18th hole of the PGA Championship or anything, so we're just trying to knock everything down. And I get a lot of people that say, you know, why don't you bag your clippings? I don't need to. Here in Florida, these clippings biodegrade in a matter of days and they provide nitrogen to the lawn, so it's free fertilizer. It doesn't make sense for me to charge more and take more time, more wear and tear on me, more time away from my family to dispose of these clippings or to bag them or any of that. It just doesn't make sense. And I hear a lot of people say, oh, no, you're wrong. It's going to smell. No, not for where I'm at. I'm not saying up in Pennsylvania you can do this. I'm saying I don't need to. What I've started doing is just posting a link to the University of Florida where they recommend it. So if you want to argue till you're blue in the face, that's fine. But the University of Florida says this is what you're supposed to do. So anyways, that's why you're going to see me mow first and then string trim later. Because it's easier for me. And because it's easier for me. Thought you guys would get a kick out of this too. This is a gallon of water that thermos I got from Costco. It works really well. Usually this is all I need to get through the day, but it holds ice for a long time and not sponsored. But man, if you're watching and you do want to sponsor, feel free. That's
good.
And while I'm thinking about it, one really good thing about the 48 inch is that on most curbs versus a 36 inch, now I only need to make two passes instead of three. And it doesn't sound like a lot, but it adds up over time. people will either complain about me discharging it towards the client's house or the neighbor's house, but I mean, these houses are like less than 20 feet apart from each other, so somebody's house is going to be hit, right? All I can do is clean it up when I'm done. I don't really know how to avoid it. Some people are going to say shoot blocker. I have not been able to mulch this quantity of grass with a shoot blocker on, unless you're willing to go like, you know, 2 miles an hour, and I'm not. I think I might be able to move that playpen. I mean, swing set. We're gonna try it. So I think that's pretty much everything. We'll find out, and I need a water break. See what I mean? Long clippings laying on the grass. We'll blow it all out and it'll be fine, but that's the idea of why you would string trim first. Thank you. And that's kind of risky too, string trimming back there, but what are you gonna do? Same thing with this kind of stuff. So you've got grounding wires everywhere. The string trimming is just not a good long-term solution for this. And neither is hand pulling. So one bad thing I have noticed about this heart, and it might not be an issue if you're a homeowner, but this bump feed head gets dirt in it and it won't feed automatically unless you take it out and clean it. So you've kind of sometimes manually have to unfeed, unspool that line. And it's because dirt gets in spots and it won't. I'll have to show you later. But again, if you're just a homeowner, I don't think that's going to be an issue. I think it's an issue for me because I'm using it commercially. There's all kind of dirt and mud that get in here from doing ponds and stuff. Thank you. The stuff I go through for you guys. Should have brought the Echo 3020. if you are ever doing anything like this, you want to go from the top down, because if you just go straight into the bottom, it's going to jam like that. If you don't leave a like on this video, I'm gonna ban you from the channel so you can never watch another one of these videos again, because this is ridiculous. And I want you to subscribe if you're not already. Now. I'm not cutting anymore until you do those things. Do I look like I'm kidding? I needed a break anyways. Thank you, I appreciate that. Was it so hard? I think the sun is really getting to me. Yeah. You can see how much those clippings are already drying out. That's after, what, 20, 30 minutes? So it's not gonna smother the lawn. This is the part where I get sick of moving the camera. So you're gonna get the real long shot of me trimming this whole fence at once. If you've got a problem with it, I'll refund you what the video cost. Can you tell the longer I'm in the sun, the meaner I get?
Thank you.